If you aren't born wealthy, you have almost no chance of ever becoming rich. There are very, very few outliers that really made it from nothing. These are paraded around like a carrot in front of the masses, and it's nonsense. If you are not already born above average in terms of wealth, there's a 99% chance that you will never get wealthy. You can be a genius, excel at HS Uni, your job. You will still never catch up to daddy's boy that got a small loan of $500,000 to start his business, whose grandfather owned 20,000 acres of land and could catch his grandson if he failed, who had all the right connections set up and had just to fall forward to be successful. People claiming all this can be achieved by working super hard are delusional and gaslighting people that had it hard for not being economically successful is even worse. Edit. For the people asking what rich is, low-level millionaire means a paid of house, paid of cars, and like 23 million in the bank account. This is low-level rich, but somewhere in this ballpark, the lowest level of rich begins. I have been so depressed lately about work. It seems like the average person is thrown into an already huge hole pre-dug while someone teases you with a carrot on a stick. If you just work hard, you'll be successful and rich. Money isn't everything and can't solve all your problems. All of my problems would be solved if I had money. Literally all of them. It's so exhausting living for everyone but yourself. All this effort put in gets other people rewarded. I knew a guy who went from poverty to $300 million when he was in his 70s. He said to me, "What's the point of being happy if you're not rich? Look at me. I'm lonely, miserable, and my family hate me. But at least I've got money." I don't understand people who just want a fulfilling life when money is obviously more important. And that's when I realized I didn't have what it took to get rich. The only time that has changed throughout the ages is during war or significant social change like revolution or autocracy. OFC, you are right. The hardest working people are those with brooms, our kitchen knives or spanners or spades, etc. The best paid ones are the ones that started off rich and spend their days on golf courses or in restaurants or private jets, working hard. It's just a shame idiots believe their propaganda. A lot depends on your definition of rich. An individual who grew up in poverty and accumulated 500k may not be wealthy but could consider themselves rich and successful. I don't even have a chance of becoming not poor. The reality is my family will most likely always be poor. In the last 3 years, we have gone from making 24k a year to almost 80k. The biggest thing though is it hasn't increased our buying power. If anything, we have less buying power than 3 years ago with the same bills and rent. All our bills and living expenses have increased except luckily our rent. If we wanted to move right now, our rent would increase 3x. It is really hard not to lose hope. A lot of these comments are missing the mark. You know exactly what rich means, and that in the US 99% of the people are not well off and comfortable or totally different from rich. Hell, don't they change what qualifies as middle class every so often? It raises with every reclassification. My first roommate in college shared a piece of wisdom his father told him. "Son, you can marry more money in 5 minutes than you can make in an entire lifetime." I also personally like to think of lottery tickets as a poor people tax. It's so enticing to get this microscopic chance at winning that a huge majority of people spend that money into the pockets of a rich dude dangling a carrot in front of us. I mean, it depends on what you consider rich. Is someone from a family with an income below 20th percentile likely to become a billionaire? No, but someone from a family with an income above the 99th percentile isn't either. It's just not something that happens very often. One way of looking at this is if you were in the top quantile of wealth in the US. There is only a 20% probability that you came from a family from between the first and third quantiles of wealth. That's not great, but it's not nothing. The primary transmission of wealth from generation to generation isn't actual money like loans, but instead knowledge, habits, and the benefits of very low stress. I think people imagine that rich people had their parents pay for college or gave them a loan. They generally don't need to. If your parents tell you early in your life, you really should prepare for one of the following careers: some form of engineering, medicine, law, or a high-ranking business school. Just that knowledge and aim early on is absolutely massive. Financially, I was on my own when I was 18. Well, the government helped a lot with loans, but Sally Mae will do that for people regardless of parents' income. But I had been gifted an absurd amount of guidance. Unfortunately, I don't think that's something that can be shoved in a book. Maybe? It's a tough problem, but there's no point in being defeated before it even begins. Working people who become wealthy are like lottery winners. I think most people differentiate between well-off, wealthy, and rich. And while people dream of being wealthy or rich, most would satisfy with being well-off. And what is that? I dunno, but it varies for every person. For some, having a house, preferably paid for, and enough to live where you can do what you want might be it. That seems to be a reasonable goal. American social mobility is very much on the decline. Someone said something to the effect of, if hard work was all you needed to be wealthy, every housekeeper would be driving a Porsche. In Germany, a newspaper recently reported that our tax burden is so high that out of 100 euros earned, you see about 23.21 euros when adding all direct and hidden taxes. If you make 100k, you are top 5%. So you have frugally 33k. Rent is around 11 euros a year depending on where you live. Then you have the highest price shock since the Bundesrepublik Germany exists. After cost of living expenses, there is nor really much to save up. Especially considering the exploding childcare cost, which can get up to 2k per month in cities like Munich. Houses in a decent condition are around 450k, very far away from major cities, and start at 800k in larger cities. 1 mil plus in Munich, Berlin, or Dusseldorf. Interest rate is between 4, 5, and 5%, meaning you pay more than 22k in interest for a house in the middle of nowhere without having paid off a single cent of the actual debt. So yeah, even if you are among the richest earners from labor, you can't afford a house. Simultaneously, Germany has only a quarter of the taxes on wealth that GB or France have. We are so goddamn funked, it's not funny anymore. Slaves for your landlords. To make matters worse, up until recently, Germany had no proper control of money laundering, and whole cities' blocks were purchased to launder money. A significant amount of landlords comes from actual criminal families. Rich kids grow up in neighborhoods with other rich kids, so they automatically have a pre-built high-end social circle of people that all have wealthy parents who create an easy path for them. So if you and all your friends are playing the game with cheat codes on, there's a greater chance you'll be successful. Google. Class mobility. This is the measure of movement between classes in a nation. And it's remarkably low in the USA. It's the highest in countries that right-wingers would be quick to call socialist. Denmark, Finland, Norway, etc. And I think the class we need to end is the top 0.1%. The top of the top 1%. This is a class that, If you are born into, it's wholly improbable that you will ever leave. Zero mobility requiring zero work or contribution to society. If you aren't born into it, it's even less probable that you will enter it. Even with wild success, billionaires need to die. Hubs and I definitely didn't grow up rich. He took a trade in high school and had great jobs. He started his own company by taking out an equity loan against our house. We now have six-figure annual income and have socked away enough to retire any time. He also treats his employees well. This is the truth, man. So many people dream of getting the high life, but wealth is inherited. The highest paying jobs will leave you with the crumbs of what the millionaires are making. You are either born into it or get in by chance. No amount of hard work will ever make you rich. Define rich. Why does someone need to become rich?
If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlists full of similar content. Epicaracast is like doom scrolling for your ears. Please like, share, and subscribe.